talk to you about how to develop creative, strong design sector in Mongolia by encouraging young people to take part in economy and create something that I would call sustainable first future of Mongolia. How this idea was developed. I arrived 1 year ago to Mongolia from Serbia, and I'm supposed to teach at the faculty. I had to know a little more about the context of architecture and design in Mongolia. I sat near my laptop and Googled a few keywords. One of those was Mongolian design, other was Mongolian architecture. What could I find? I found more about history of Mongolian architecture, some extraordinary, amazing vernacular architecture of Mongolia, and architecture of Buddhist temples. But when we are talking about Mongolian design, I couldn't find nothing more about Mongolian patterns, Mongolian arts and crafts. What I was looking for actually is to find some significant brands, some interesting young creative people, some strong creative practices. Then a few of my helpful friends tried to help me to understand more about developing of Mongolia. This is one of the projects that is going to be built. It's called Nuht Village. And I said, great, in 1 year, if I get tired of all this gear, yurt, and this kind of vernacular architecture, and I will be missing my Europe, I will buy here some pseudo Spanish Californian villa, if I get enough money, of course. The other type of development is actually something that is mixed-use development, high-rise building, hospitality buildings that you can find anywhere else in the world. Nothing about something typical about design spirit of Mongolia. Then they tried to impress me about luxury villas. One of those villas is for well-off population in Mongolia that actually really remind me of the Hermitage Museum in St. Petersburg. It's all about how to revive Rococo style and all other neoclassical styles of the history. The other type of development is about hospitality and what we are going to offer to tourists that come in Mongolia. I understood that Mongolian people are somehow have like difficulties to decide. Will they offer luxury hotels or something that is deeply rooted in tradition? Even this Tiroj hotel is nothing original. I can compare it to the Palazzo Versace in Dubai. Even interior is complete replica of this interior. I was asking myself why these people try to copy all these things from outside, either to revive neoclassical styles or to reproduce all these buildings from London, Dubai, and other cities. When they have everything, what is the best of everything possible that you can find, and I went to visit the Winter Palace Bohan, and I was truly amazed what I could find here. That would be a great starting point for our new luxury of Mongolia. There are other type of the people in Mongolia, young, modern, contemporary people studied outside, saw different things. They want to have some contemporary villa. This is one of the villa they showed me in Azizan, $5 million villa. This is first thing that they told me. And I said, okay, this is nothing extraordinary special. This is minimalistic, contemporary interior. They went to the Italy, they bought the best of the Missoni furniture, they brought it back to Mongolia, and they offered to Mongolian people for $5 million. Yeah. The other type of development is related to the Mongolian pride. Here we can see a large Morinhur music instrument. Once again, it's nothing new in a history of architecture. I can compare it to the similar idea of Adolf Loos almost 100 years ago when he tried to enlarge column to the extent of the tower. And I would just say some projects should never be built. The other project is actually trying to compete with the best of the monuments in the world. So, this project is about huge Buddhist statue with, again, a large stupa behind that will be some conventional religious center. I would just encourage people not to think in a way, let's make it better, bigger, and more challenging. You have nothing to fight, to compare with others. You already have a lot of very interesting things. Obviously, this project is going to be built. Then I rented my flat near Tengi Cinema, and I had to decorate it. And they took me to the Michel Expo where all of you are buying your furniture, carpets, and I had to buy carpet. At that time, I didn't know that this type of the decoration is not intended to be used on the floor because I was not ready to vacuum clear my Genghis Khan. And even worse, I was not ready to step on him. I could imagine his angry face all the time. What were my objectives and my responsibility as a teacher in Mongolia? I was thinking, I have one option. These people have really huge need for architects and designers. I can embrace all these possibilities, stick myself to 1 year in Mongolia, get rich and go. How convenient. The other approach would like, let's solve some problems. There are a lot of problems that you have with the gear, district, with development, urban planning. Or I can create something that I would call, let's encourage people, let's unlock their creativity and prepare them for the future of design in Mongolia. First, a starting point in this process to recognize what you already have. And you have a lot. One of these amazing things is about extraordinary vernacular architecture. Even after a year and 3 months, I still believe it's something the most perfect that you can find in Mongolia. Then you have various building technologies, extraordinary colorful floral patterns, different tribes and entities that live in Mongolia, each of them with a very rich culture background. Then you have highly intelligent Mongolian games from wood and made from metal. Then again, about Mongolian floral patterns, geometrical patterns, things that you use from wool, from leather, from wood, highly decorated saddles, something that you cannot find anywhere in the world. Then we're speaking how we can create something that is able to build future of design in Mongolia. I would call it, we need to build creative economy. What is creative economy? On one side, we have culture and tradition. On other side, we have industry. They need something in between as medium to establish dialogue between the culture and between the industry. This is obviously design. I'm twin, my brother is twin, so I found this as a very good example. So first thing, we need to protect creative commons for the young designers, architects, and artists. So we need to build legal framework for people to be encouraged to design and not someone else to steal their idea. So unless we are talking about twins, we cannot replicate anything else. I would share some experience for my country. This was a long process, how we started from social realism to very long transitional period, how we reached the global market. We can establish all this system by having some interesting design events. This is a design event in Serbia called Mixer Festival, where we occupied all the abandoned harbor in Belgrade and whole city breed design these 7 days. The other way is to create design platforms, when people can publish their ideas, they can discuss, they can exchange, not be afraid that we'll be exposed. How to go back? No back. Okay. This is very interesting competition about how to encourage young designers to give their proposals and ideas. And they call it first Serbian young designers and then later young Balkan designers. You can see this is all live people, so designers are as any other professionals. And they design some very extraordinary furniture designs. They create, they made, produce prototypes and using local materials. Then later they invited local furniture company to use some of these ideas and award them and actually put them in a mass production. That was a really huge success on market on furniture in Serbia. Then we have Design Week. Every year we have, since 2006, Design Week with a different topic and different theme. And I was part of this Design Week 2006 still as a student. Few of us designed some non-standard installation and we found money and we actually built it on one of the main pedestrian areas. How excited we were. Also, we were excited to meet some world famous designers. This is Karim Rashid. Even he was more excited to talk to pretty Serbian girls. Obviously, he got married to one. Then, this is something very important. This is the new concept, and it's called design laboratory. Actually, what does it mean, design laboratory? You have all these young designers, architects, creative minds. They have good skills, but they don't have money to start their business. They're able to rent for a low price one working space and with allied people work together and build their businesses. They're not only working there, they're exchanging their ideas. This is me, part of one workshop back like 2 years ago. I was working very hard. One woman came from Sweden, from IKEA, gave us very interesting task, and we were all working how to design some interior elements, interior products. But all these independent design events sometimes are not enough. Government needs to recognize this is potential. This is one agency called SIEPA, which means Serbian Investment and Export Promotional Agency. Very complicated name, but says everything. Investment, helping people to recognize what are key industries and bring their money inside of Serbia. Then, they're promoting what is the best of Serbia to export. And they categorize these possibilities and they encourage people to export. Actually, all the products that are made more than 80% in Serbia can be exported without customs. And then they promote all these Serbian young designers, architects, creative minds. Or we have very interesting, this is Novak Djokovic, yes. We have all these interesting manufacturers, small businesses. They want to sell their products. If they're all dispersed, they will not do much. We need to gather them. And this is the website, actually online shop, that actually shows all the products that we can find and related to very traditional products of Serbia. I was lucky to teach at the faculty. I had an idea that my responsibility is really huge. My contract is only 2 years, but I said I can do something. I took students out of the country. I wanted them to be moved by seeing cutting-edge design of the London. Where else than London? They still, till today, review their memories, they share experience they learned there, and trying to reach the best through their design. Then we visited lighting design studio. Anna shared with us how actually you developed lighting project for some interiors. They were all like, that's amazing. We don't have this in Mongolia. Then we visited one of the very successful architecture studios, Katy Perry, and then one of the partners, he showed us their workshop where they make models, where they produce ideas, how they develop concepts. It was very useful for us all. Then I was like thinking, what I'm doing? I'm giving students some tasks that are staying on the paper. Let me bring them out. I told them, this term we are going to design and redesign the offices, spaces for United Nations. They were scared. They said, there is no way that we'll go out. They were scared of the failure. They were kept on talking, we are not good enough, we cannot do it, we cannot do it. Because environment here doesn't encourage them. But then, through the process of very creative development, they undertook some series of research related to Mongolian tradition, relating to United Nations. And they experimented with design. They couldn't believe at the end how highly quality interior design projects they developed. So I will show you a few of the students' work. This is the idea for a lobby of United Nations. You can see some idea taken and they get inspired by vernacular architecture. Other idea also for the lobby of United Nations, inspired by the circle and all the sun movement that you have here in Mongolia. You know that better than me. The other student got inspired by the olive leaves, and she translated that olive leaves into multifunctional conference table that can be adjusted to different needs of the United Nations officers. Then this is Nyamka's projects. She was really impressed with the Mongolian geometrical patterns, and through some series of abstraction and manipulation, she translated all these patterns into the custom-made furniture for the offices, and it was a very successful proposal. Then, in some other modules, I gave students tasks You choose one Mongolian pattern and try to design the furniture. This is very new thing for them. How you can use Mongolian pattern that we use in a Buddhist temple and then you apply in as a furniture. But this student made it. This is very interesting multifunctional custom-made cabinet that actually on the front you can see one drawer that looks like Mongolian pattern, and we have other department for different use and different tools that you can place there. The other student got inspired by floral pattern and she designed a lamp. Lamp that is highly interesting because it's using cutting-edge technology laser cut in the brushed steel, but still we can recognize traditional floral pattern. Other student got inspired by, how you say, call this? Arg. Okay. So this is a basket where you carry on many things. And then she got inspired and created furniture that has three parts. Each of these parts can go inside of each other and then can be used as a cabinet, shelf, flexible piece of furniture. Then last week I gave the task to high school students. I told them I have really difficulties to find a carpet. You have task to design contemporary carpet that uses felt, that uses wool, stitches, and you are gonna design, put your ideas on a paper. I got various very interesting ideas from the inspiration from the nature and animals, from the gear, floral ideas, geometrical ideas, traditional religious ideas. It was very interesting working with them. At the end, I would say this, world around us, especially here in Mongolia, cannot be seen only in one way. When you design and create things, you don't need to copy-paste what you already saw outside. You don't need to compare yourself. You don't need to be better than others. Some of us may see here settings for a campfire, but other creative people will actually get inspired for a joints, for the furniture. What we shall do in this? We need to unlock possibilities, to unlock all these creative minds, and create supportive system for them to reach the industry. Thank you very much.